When a childhood cancer cell goes awry, it probably happens fairly quickly over a relatively short period of time. Whereas we think a lot of adult cancers arise over the course of several years. Maybe there's a chronic irritation, let's say in a smoker, or in the case of colon cancer, we know that it occurs over the course of many years, which is why colonoscopy, you know, can prevent it, because you find the preliminary version of it so early. Childhood cancer probably happens like a switch. And it's partly because the cells are so malleable, and if the wrong mutation happens at the wrong time, you're all the way to the cancer state. Now, what does that mean? That means that if you find an abnormality in childhood cancer, a genetic abnormality, it's likely to be part and parcel of the whole process. We call it driver mutations, or the drivers of the cancer process. So in general, childhood cancers are every bit as aggressive, maybe even more so than adult cancers, but they're simpler from a genetic standpoint. It seems as if it's mostly the drivers that appear when you go looking. Whereas in the adult cancers, you're often looking at for a needle in a haystack. There might be tons of abnormalities, many of which are irrelevant. They've just been accumulated over time. Childhood cancer has all of the essential elements of adult cancer. It is highly malignant. It is aggressive. It metastasizes. But it's different from adult cancer in that it is in some ways a simpler version of the adult cancers. Childhood cancers in general, I would say, are more aggressive than adult tumors if you just look on average. And that might be why they respond better to chemotherapy. We've had more success over the last 50 years against childhood cancer than adult cancers. And part of that is that responsiveness to chemo. And it's not entirely clear how the simpler makeup of the childhood cancer relates to the chemosensitivity. I think we don't understand that very well. But childhood cancers do respond to chemotherapy better than adult cancers in general. The Target Initiative was a sort of big science initiative that involved a collaboration between many of the greatest minds in pediatric cancer today to try to catalog the genetic, I want to say abnormalities, but they're not all abnormal cells. Some of these are normal, there aren't all abnormal genes. Some of these are normal genes. So to catalog the goings-on of the inside of the cancer cell, and they focused on a few tumors. We haven't done it for the entire array of childhood tumors, but the area where it's come out to be most informative of late, I think one could say, is in acute lymphoblastic leukemia. Acute lymphoblastic leukemia is the most common childhood cancer. It's been one of the great success stories, with an overall survival rate of now of about 85%. But there are still some subsets of patients who don't enjoy that kind of, you know, good prognosis. And the TCGA target type initiative has been very focused on looking at those poor prognosis or the high risk versions of childhood ALL. And they have identified a remarkable array of genes that are abnormal in these childhood leukemias. And some of them are what you would find in, say, an adult leukemia like CML, the classical Philadelphia chromosome. But they've also found a whole array of abnormalities that make the cancer act like it has that translocation, but it in fact doesn't. And this has come out just in the last 6 months or so, and has really opened up a whole array of new targets for childhood leukemia. And it taught us that childhood leukemia, there are many different ways the cancer cell can use, many different pathways the cancer cell can use to get to this point of pediatric ALL. And that's daunting in a way, because trying to target all those different pathways is going to be really challenging. But it's incredibly informative, because it's telling us the many ways in which the tumor cell can go from, you know, to its malignant state. And I'm going to guess that some of this is also going to be applicable to adult leukemia when they look. Compared to adult cancer, childhood cancer is much more rare if you just look at sheer numbers. Overall, it makes up about 4% of all cancers diagnosed. However, if you look at the years of life lost due to deaths from childhood cancer, it's much higher than that 4%. So I don't want to minimize the importance of the problem. But the point that the numbers of sheer numbers of patients with cancer are so much less than for adult cancers has meant that childhood cancer specialists have long been faced with the challenges of accruing patients to trials when it's a rare disease. And we've addressed that problem, I think, in a very effective way, and the name of the game is collaboration. You don't go off by yourself and try to do this at one hospital or another hospital. Childhood cancer specialists from the get-go, really from the 60s, have been collaborating extensively, doing cooperative group trials, and referring patients to the centers where the very novel therapies are being undertaken. And so it is a challenge. It's always a challenge trying to study new therapies in rare diseases, but it's one that we have faced for a long time, and we've been able to make steady progress despite the challenge.